What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. So, of course, you already know what time it is. It's Wednesday. It's Real Talk Wednesday. It is early in the morning. It's 8:55 a.m. here, which on the East Coast, it's 10:55 a.m. And I know you guys are like, damn, you're doing it early, but I'd like to get it out the way. So that's why I look like this early in the morning. So for all of y'all bitches who always kept asking in my videos indirectly, because when I say indirectly, I mean, you didn't ask me. You just asked whoever would answer you. Does she have hair? A bitch does have hair, okay? So, this is my hair for today. I've been wearing it out for like 5 days. Like 5 Saturdays. Right? 5 days. So, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Five days to be exact. Because I washed it and I really didn't feel like wearing a wig, so that is the reason why it is up in a bun like this. So I have enough hair, enough for a bun. Well, I have more than enough for a bun. This is my own hair in a bun. It's probably like right here, shoulder length, because I did cut it. I cut a lot of it off because it was damaged. You know something? A lot of people ask me, why don't I wear my own hair out? I thought you didn't have any hair because you wore a wig. Like, just because you wear a wig does not mean that you're a baldy locks. You know what I'm saying? Like, bitch, no, I have hair. Just because I wear a wig does not mean I don't have any. It's an accessory. Like, you wear necklaces, earrings, bracelets. I wear a wig. It's accessory, just like a purse. Depending on what outfit I want to wear, it's what hair I want to wear. So, yes, just because you wear weave doesn't mean you're bald. Means that you want to wear fucking hair, okay? So, over the years, I have been wearing a wig since my daughter, Mumsy, was about 1 year old. And I haven't stopped wearing them since. And I wear them because it just gives me and allows me to be versatile. And I don't have to mess with my own hair. I've had issues with my own hair as a kid growing up that it's thin. When I'm saying thin, meaning it's fine texture. It really doesn't hold a curl too well. Maybe now because I'll know what to do to it. But it really doesn't hold a curl too well. And I don't really like to dye it. So, and I don't like to cut my hair because I feel like it's my powers. And if you cut my hair, I'm just going to lose every last bit of my powers. So that is the reason why I wear a wig. And if you have worn a wig for as long as I have all these years, then babies, trust and believe, when it's time to do your own hair, you are just lost. You just be like, what? So, like, what do I do now? What do I do? So I'm trying to be a little bit more hands-on with my hair these days and do my own shit. We're going to see how long that works out, okay? So, yes, I do have fucking hair. Other than that, I'm so pissed off this morning because really I was supposed to go to the dentist and be there at 8:30 in the a.m., but it was pouring raining outside, and that kind of conflicted with my walk. So, you know, I go and do my 3-mile walk every day at like 8:05 a.m., and it's 8:05 because by the time I get back from dropping my daughter off, it's like 8:05. And I'll just hop out the car and just walk. So that kind of like pissed me off because I really don't like anything to interfere with my walk. And also, so I called them and I wasn't really in a good mood because it was pouring outside. It was like pouring raining. And I love it when it's gloomy and I just want to not do anything. And also, I wasn't in the mood to give them $390 today. Like, you got to be in a good mood to just want to give money away. Like, I know I'm that way. So I said, I'm just going to stay home and I'll go next week. Well, why did it just get sunny out like 3 minutes before I started doing this video, which was like, come on now. I could have went on a fucking walk. It stopped raining like at 8:15. I'm so pissed off because I didn't get to go today because of the dentist and the weather. I didn't get to go yesterday because I had a hangover. And on Saturdays, I don't go because I just don't go because I think that walking 3 miles out of 6 days a week is like beneficial. And I didn't go Sunday because, well, it was that time where I just didn't feel like getting up on the weekend. I just had a lot on my mind. So I figured take off 2 days. So I'll take off the weekends from now on and walk Monday through Friday, which is good. Even my doctor was like, why do you walk so much? That's a lot of walking. So what? The fuck you worried about it for? So I decided to take off 2 days, the weekends, because then I could get to sleep in late. And my sleeping late is more or less like I want to be up by like at least 8:45 on the weekends because I don't want the whole day to go by. So that's me sleeping in late, not past like 8:30. I'd be pissed off if it's after 8:30 a.m. I don't know why, but, you know, I just don't really like to sleep in that late. So I'm really pissed off about that. And the sun has been shining bright. And then now, once again, the clouds are over. So if it rains, I'll be really happy because at least I feel like, okay. Or I'll just go for a walk later on this evening for 3 miles. Either way, I'm not too happy with the weight loss journey. And I'm going to be honest and tell you guys that I'm just not. Probably because I just feel like I'm still like overweight. Like I walked 3 miles a day, 6 days out of the week. Shit, that's a lot of fucking miles. That's 18 miles. And I don't feel like my body is toning up. Maybe I'm just impatient, but I'm just going to continue doing what I'm doing. I've downloaded a new app where I can do 15-minute or 5-minute work abs. And I'm going to give it some months, a few months, a couple months. Because if my stomach doesn't go down in a couple months, then I'm just going to think about getting surgery, like cosmetic surgery. Like a body sculpting or something. You know, they do all kind of shit out here. So it's not expensive at all. And I've been saving my coins. So a bitch should treat herself. You know, so it's either I get that done. Well, I'm gonna try my best to not have to get it done because I really don't like to spend my money. So yes. But other than that, everything is cool and fine. Oh my God, my daughter and her freaking electronics, like, be scaring the shit out of me. Yeah, so everything is cool and fine. My keloid is still there. The treatment is making it go down a lot. If you guys can tell, it's a lot flatter. And that is from me picking at it right there. But it is a lot flatter. A whole lot flatter. And I'm happy about that. Super happy about that. So, yes, hunties, yes. Let's get this real talk going on. If you have a real talk situation that you want me to address, you can go ahead and send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com and put in the subject line real talk so that I know it is a real talk situation. So that way when I do my search on my channel of real talk, it will come up. Now, keep in mind, ladies, and gents, that just because you send me a real talk today doesn't mean I'm going to do it next Wednesday, because just keep in mind, there are people ahead of you, okay? So sometimes I get to them probably like a couple weeks later than expected. And in case you guys are wondering about my eyebrows, they have been growing back in. That's why they look like this right now. Like, I refuse to tweeze them because I really want them to just fully grow all the way in. So that way I can really, really, really get the eyebrow look that I want. Like, for real. So, yeah, I get tired of drawing them on all the time. So, yes. Really, really. So, if you see, my brows are not that great. That's because I'm letting them grow in. So anyway, let's get on to this real talk. And like I was saying, make sure you put in the subject line real talk. And also, if you need to change the names of the subjects in the email, please let me know ahead of time in the very beginning. You can basically say, I've already changed the names for you. That's it. Okay, so this one has been titled Real Talk, Crazy Ass Black Man. I know a couple of them. Hey, April, I am, but you can call me Lady. Well, for starters, I have this insane, crazy ass black man who is my neighbor that every fall he has his nose up my ass because I have a tree in my yard that drops lots of leaves during the fall. I have a yard service that mows my grass and gets up my leaves for me in the fall. It is expensive to pay for yard service. He has had this idea that because the tree is in my yard, he can blow leaves back into my yard from his yard. I have lived there 15 years. They have lived there in their house over a decade, I think. I found him with his leaf blower blowing leaves to a pile that the yard service left to come back and pick up from my home later with their vacuum truck. My neighbor swears to me the lawn service blew the leaves over into his driveway and up under his closed gate and under his truck. It has been windy on and off, and I told him they would not do that. I have stood and watched him from my upstairs window blow leaves from his yard into mine. I have told him that I have watched him do this, and he has still denied it. He told me, well, I'm just blowing them into the pile that they left to get up when I questioned him on the day he claimed my yard service blew these leaves into his yard. I told him, so every leaf off of the tree in your yard, you're going to blow back into mine, right? LOL. He does not like me because some years back, he would let people at his house block my driveway with their car or truck or whatever type of vehicle. And I called him out on it, and he still brings that shit up. Accused me of jumping on him about it, and et cetera, et cetera. I told him he would not want me to block his driveway, so why do that to me? We have a double driveway, but one side is his, and the other side is how I enter my garage, which is mine. He has so many trucks and cars and vehicles that he fills his driveway with. Now, April, we live in a subdivision. He has at least two trucks, two minivans. They have to parallel park behind one another and exit on my side of the driveway to get out. I'm sick of them. I even called the police once because he was letting people that visited his home continue to block my driveway. Any suggestions for me, as this is a crazy, angry-ass black man? He has also said something about the neighbor across the street. They talked to me about how we used to get along. April, I don't know nothing about their ass, and I don't even know his crazy ass name. After all these years, I don't know them. I just retired, and I did not even know what he looked like until lately because I used to work 12-hour shifts, so I never was able to see them. I live alone, and I'm single, and I mind my own business. Please help. So a lady has a crazy ass black man as a neighbor, and he is basically just doing some real disrespectful shit, blowing leaves, okay, which is petty. Like, why would you be so petty? Pick them shits up, or if you want to blow the leaves that's on your lawn into hers, at least have the decency to say, hey, listen, is it okay if I blow the leaves over? Because I know you have the yard service. I can give you a couple dollars, you know, to put towards it. That's the least thing that you could do. You know what I'm saying? That's, if that were me, that's what I would do. At least I would. Me, honestly, I wouldn't even do that. I would just get my own shit up, okay? That's what you got kids for. You rake your leaves up and you put them in a bag and you pitch them in yourself. That's what I would do. I'm not about to pay for no yard service because I'm too damn cheap. I'm not about to blow my leaves on nobody else's lawn neither. However, if you that cheap and you that motherfucking petty, then the least you can do is ask your neighbor, before you start blowing shit on their fucking lawn, do you mind if I place my leaves on your pile? And I'll be more than happy to give you some money for it because I know you have a yard service and it would make things a lot easier for me. That's the least you could do if you want to be that cheap and petty. You know what I'm saying? But you ain't about to just come over here and blow your fucking leaves on my lawn for nothing. Like, that's petty. But on my part, I'm not being petty because I pay for my service and you ain't about to use my service. But here's the different thing. You block in my driveway. Like, I can't stand that shit. That's a pet peeve of mine. When people's cars be in front of my driveway, they don't block my driveway, but they'll probably have like this much of a car into my driveway space. Like, excuse you. And sometimes I could be on some petty shit. Like, you know that shit is not part of the motherfucking street, okay? You see my car up in this bitch. I'm supposed to just swerve around and get out. I don't have to do all of that. This is my driveway. I could just get the fuck out however I want. Oops, if I hit your motherfucking car. Shouldn't have been here in the first place. But, you know, what I had to do before, and I noticed that this shit, this is not here. This wasn't here in Arizona. This was in New York. When I was living in New York, I don't really like people blocking my driveway at all. Really, just, I would appreciate it if you don't block my motherfucking driveway. So, first of all, you can tell it's a driveway if you see a car up in there. But this dumb bitch, she did it several occasions. She, like, literally blocked the motherfucker. There was no, I didn't have, like, a wide driveway. It was, like, a narrow driveway, and it was just enough for me to get in and get out. I couldn't, like, swerve around or do anything like that because, first of all, there are buildings and houses right next to each other, so there was no room for me to fucking drive up on a curb. So I watched her fucking do this one time, and I was sitting out on the porch. The other two times, I didn't see the bitch. So I left a note on her car the second time. Because the first time I noticed it, she was getting in the car, leaving. So I can't say nothing to you because you're leaving. The second time I noticed it, I didn't know whose car it was, like meaning where the person was, what house the person was in. So it's not like I could go around and ring everybody's doorbell on the block. But I wasn't going to be that petty to get your shit towed because I wasn't going anywhere. Had I been going some other fucking place, bitch, you best believe your shit would have been towed. I could care less, all right? I'm not about to stand out here and beat my motherfucking horn and be stressed the fuck out. I'm going to have your shit towed if I got to get the fuck out. And it's plainly obvious, especially in the daytime. And it doesn't even matter what type of day it is. When you get out the car, you see a driveway and you see another car. You can tell that you're parking in front of somebody's driveway. Like, seriously, who does that? You know what I'm saying? So I left a note, and I said on the note, if you park in my driveway, if you block my driveway again, you're gonna find your car towed when you come back out. So obviously you knew who put it there because you just blocked my motherfucking driveway again. So I guess the bitch didn't pay attention to the post-it note that was on her motherfucking car. And the next time, that same motherfucker came right there with her car. So it was daytime, and I said, you know what? I'm going to sit right here on my fucking porch, and I'm going to wait. I had to wait that long. This, like, Hispanic bitch came outside. I was getting a car. This is me, and I'm not being petty because I'll be on some real shit. Do you see that this is the driveway? Oh, I'm sorry. Do you see that this is a driveway? I said I was sorry. It doesn't matter if you're sorry. You see it's a driveway. Do you think it's okay to be cool and just block my motherfucking driveway? This is the third time you done blocked my goddamn driveway. The next motherfucking time you block my motherfucking driveway, you're not gonna have a car. Do you understand me? She didn't say a goddamn thing. She got in her car and drove the fuck off. And guess what? That bitch ain't never parked in front of my driveway again because she probably thought I was crazy. Now, see, there's a lot of rules to driving and the road and all of this shit. And I'm not one for road rage, but you ain't about to disrespect me when it comes to parking. You ain't about to disrespect me when it comes to driving on the street, okay? Another incident. I'm on the freeway. I don't play because these people out here in Arizona can't drive for shit. You got all this road. Y'all bitches still can't drive? Like, come on. Y'all be having accidents like crazy. You can only imagine. I'm on the freeway. You know, I'm trying to get over. There's a lot of space for me to get over to the left lane so I can be in the middle. The car that I'm trying to get over in front of, this bitch is way back. There's enough space and time. My bitch know how to drive. Did this fucking bitch speed her motherfucking car up on purpose when she see me put my blinkers on and just sped the fuck up? And then she's right here at me. We're driving on the freeway. And this was like a couple days ago. Me and Tati and Tiki's in the car. I fucking rolled my windows down and was like, bitch, I'ma fuck you up. Don't play with me on this goddamn freeway. Don't fucking play with me. She got so scared. She was like, just go. And she slowed the fuck down. I don't play that shit when it comes to freeway shit and driving because if you make me have a fucking accident, I'ma get out this motherfucker and I'ma hurt you. Like, serious. You gonna get fucked up along with your car is gonna get fucked up if I have an accident. So I just like for people to stay the fuck away from me when it comes to anything when it has to do with driving. And as far as blocking your driveway, sweetheart, let me tell you something. There's always one way to take care of that shit. You have said enough to this man about blocking your motherfucking driveway and shit. Now what you gonna do is this. Don't leave no notes. Don't say anything no more. Call up the tow service and get his shit towed. It's just that simple. Just that simple. What the fuck they gonna do? Get mad with you? You should have never had your car blocking my driveway. I've said this to you on many occasions. So now this is the fucking repercussions. This is what the fucking punishment is gonna be for you. Pay for your shit to get out of tow. Bottom line, you're not gonna go back and forth with somebody about blocking your driveway. This is some shit that I wouldn't even bother to do. You're not gonna continuously block my fucking driveway. No, and then I'm not gonna keep saying anything to you about it. And I'm not gonna keep fighting and arguing with you over it. And we're not about to have a physical fight because I'm too old for that shit. However, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna serve you one even better. I'm gonna hit you where it really hurts. I'm gonna have your shit the fuck towed. And now you're gonna pay for it. You're gonna pay for the towing service of them towing it the fuck away. And you're gonna have to pay for the time it sat in the lot, okay? So you're probably gonna end up paying anywhere from $65 to $100 that day if you get it out that day, which maybe that'll teach you a lesson, okay? A lesson well learned. Now, as for the piling up of the leaves, you know what? The next time you see him watching him from your window, don't wait until he's done. Go and catch him in the act, because then he can't deny anything. Take pictures is what I would do. And if you, since you live in a subdivision, you have to live in like a subdivision where it's like an HOH, where they, the HOA, what is it, HOH housing? I forget what it stands for, HOA or HOH. I think it's HOA because I have one here. Basically, it's with the nosy motherfucking organization. It's an organization or group where you live in a subdivision and they have their own set of rules. Don't have your garbage cans out since after a certain time. Don't block on the driveway. They have certain rules and shit like that. So if I were you, I would contact them about him with the leaf situation. You know what I'm saying? Take pictures, show what he's doing. And just because it's a tree that's from your side of the lawn doesn't give him the right to fucking blow the leaves into your yard, okay? Those leaves don't necessarily have to be from you, your tree. They're surrounding homes, which can easily blow. You know, I used to get all kind of shit blown on my lawn, and I would think that people would just leave it there on purpose. But the way that my lawn was set up, you know, like my bank account, but my lawn, it would blow stuff from down the street onto my lawn and into the back of my house. And it would just piss me off because I would think that somebody is doing that. And the same thing happens here. And I would think, like, why is this shit blowing on my lawn? I don't even eat Arby's or Jack in the Box. We don't eat that shit here. But it has to do with it, the way the direction is blowing. So, you know what I'm saying? Your leaves or his leaves don't necessarily have to be your leaves. But I would definitely have his shit the fuck towed. You want to be angry black man? Well, I'm going to be an angry black woman, and I'm going to have your cars towed. I don't give a fuck whose cars it is. I'm not even going to question and ask. I wouldn't even give him any forewarning because you've already done that. What I would do is I would have his shit fucking towed. Bottom line. You know, you play nice and you play nice, but people take advantage of you. And you can continuously play nice if you want to, or you could just take it into the next steps and the matters in your own hand. Trust and believe. Ain't nobody got time to be going back and forth with neighbors about little petty things, okay? Just have the shits told. Just have the shits told. So, and next one, okay? So, this one is a little long, but it's very interesting, all right? And it kind of got to me when I was reading it, so yes. Hey, Miss April, you can call me Grace. I have already changed the names. I am 29 years old and have been married to my husband, Eric, for over 5 years now. He is not the kind of man I thought I'd end up with. He's quiet, serious nerd, but I adore him and he treats me well. Our relationship is overall very good. We plan on buying a house and having a baby within the next couple of years. All was good until an old fling started flirting with me on Snapchat. His name is Ben, and we went to high school together. For some reason, Ben has always been hot for me. He has model good looks, and he's generally a good guy. We messed around twice back in the day, but we never had sex. We stay in touch and chat every once in a while on social media, since he now lives about 7 hours away from our hometown. Our conversations have always just been friendly and basic until recently. I am average looking and I'm about a size 14, but for some reason, Ben thinks I'm the sexiest person ever. He has had a huge crush on me since we were 16. He is very handsome and has a perfect hot body. My husband honestly isn't very good looking, but it never really mattered to me. The attention from Ben has made me feel so good. He has a girlfriend who he has been with for a year or two now, but he said he would break up in a heartbeat if I decided I wanted him. I haven't sent any inappropriate pictures, but our conversations have been very suggestive and sexual. He is so sexy, and it's hard to believe he wants me. It started out with us reminiscing about the times we had together and what could have been. He regrets not asking me out when he had the chance, and now I'm someone else's wife. He said he didn't think I'd want to date him, so he was always too shy to ask. He was very shy and never did date in high school, so I believe him. We only flirted through Snapchat for a few days until he stopped replying to my messages. It really upset me when he would read or view my messages and just ignore me. At this point, I realized that this might be going past flirty and flattery. I realized I might be catching feelings. I never thought I would be tempted to cheat on my husband. He is the person I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. But since Ben and I have been talking, he's all I can think about. Today, I sent him one final message on Snapchat saying, simply, I guess you don't want to talk anymore, so I won't keep bothering you. He wrote back and said, it's not that. You're married. What's the point? I feel like maybe he started having feelings for me and realized he was in too deep, so he bailed out. Whatever the case, I really miss flirting with him and feel heartbroken. I feel foolish and guilty because I am married to a great man and I know it. I know it's for the best that Ben and I cut contact for a while. Eventually, we will probably resume just having a clean, friendly chat a couple times a year like we had been. I'm sorry this was really long and complicated, but basically, I just want your thoughts and advice. The takeaway from this is that I feel guilty for being tempted by another man. I want to give my husband 100% as he deserves, but I still have Ben on my mind. All right, Grace. So now I think you're being real fucking petty and stupid and foolish. So you're 29 years old. You've been with your husband for 5 years. He ain't the type of man you thought you would be with, but he's a good man. He's a nerd. He's a gentleman and et cetera, et cetera. And now you get back in touch with your high school fling who's been flirting with you and y'all getting really sexual and flirty and flattery. And now you feel like, you know what I'm saying, some bullshit like he wants you and all of this shit. And now you catching feelings for him. Let me tell you something, Grace. Catch your graces, okay? Because the man, Ben, was not fucking wanting you. He was just passing the time on social media. And that's what I'm gonna call it. Some bitches get so strung up on all these little social media chats and shit like that, that they be ready to drop their motherfucking kids off, drop their bank account, drop their drawers and their pets to a dog kennel and say, I'm fucking running away with this nigga for the week, for life, because he done flirted with me on social media. I'ma leave my husband of 5 years, who is a really good man, for some guy who's got a sexy ass body. How you know this man who was shy back in the days and got a sexy ass body ain't no motherfucking dog, male chauvinist pig, or just a fucking hoe? All right? Like, really, let's get realistic. You are talking to him through Snapchat. You can't even talk to him verbally over the phone because you married and he got a girlfriend. Like, I'm serious. Like, some females just take men and relationships for granted. Y'all be complaining about, oh, I can't find a good man. I wish I had a good man. Blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera. And then when you get one, you'll know how to motherfucking act because he may not look like a GQ Negro or a motherfucking actor or somebody that's just like real sexy. And then you get a dude who come along who look like all that and then some. And then y'all ready to drop your motherfucking panties and your husband and kids off to God knows where and just leave with this dude because he done fucking gave you a smiley face and a thumbs up on social media. I'm like, seriously, get it together, Grace, because you too old for this bullshit. You 29 years old. You've been married to this man for 5 years and you was cheating and flirting with him on social media. However, had he done that shit to you, would be fucking emailing me crying, talking about, should I leave him or should I stay? I don't know what to do because he just disrespected me and he was cheating and smiling at the girl on social media. Like, let's be real. I'm gonna be real with you and keep it real with you. That shit is not cool what the fuck you were doing. That's all the way wrong. Okay, all the way wrong. You just sat here and told me, or emailed me rather, that you got a good husband. He's a nerd. First of all, being a nerd is in, okay? I don't know about being stupid and sexy, but being a nerd is motherfucking in. I'd rather have a smart, ugly ass man, a smart, good, ugly ass man, than have a man that's real sexy nasty and treats me like shit and is a hoe. And is dumb. Like, let's just be realistic. Because, I mean, really, that cute shit gets worn out real motherfucking fast, okay? Real quick, okay? Like, when I say real quick, it gets worn out real quick. So what, you handsome and good looking? There's a whole bunch of other ones like you. And what you think ain't cute, Grace, might be real cute to the next bitch like me, okay? Or somebody else. Meaning, because you think your husband ain't got looks like that, that's your opinion. But I bet you somebody else will find him whole hella attractive than you do and appreciate him whole hella more than you do. Yes, you are right. You should feel motherfucking guilty because this is your husband and you sneaking behind his back on social media. And then you catching feelings and then you getting mad with the Negro because he ain't writing you and answering your messages. Damn right you married. So what's the point? What's the motherfucking point? Because like I said, and I'm gonna bring this back, had it been your husband that did this to you, bitch, you would be emailing me crying, talking about he hurt me and I can't stand him. Why does he have to treat me like this? Bitch, don't be unappreciative, okay, and ungrateful for what you got. Be happy. He don't have to look like a GQ nigga on a magazine post, but be happy that you got a man that treats you golden and treats you like something. Because that's hard to find, okay? With the way the world is today and the way people are, you got a good person. Fuck, so what? He's nerdy. Who gives a fuck? I would be happy that you had a nerdy guy. I'd be happy if my kids got a nerdy boyfriend. Nerdy the fuck is in. Let's think about it. The nigga's nerdy, which means cha-ching, he getting paper, which means he got a fucking mind on his head and he's smart, meaning we not gonna suffer in life, okay, because he's smart and he's nerdy. He wants to do something with himself, not be a fucking dumb nigga who want to live off of somebody. I'm just saying, maybe I have the wrong outlook on life and things, but I am 42 years old, and I'm really not concerned about the nigga looking like he's hell of a sexy. Honestly, I really don't want him to look hell of a sexy and handsome and all of this shit, because then I gotta fight off the other bitches that be looking at him and side-eyeing him and shit. I don't really want to have to fucking do that every day. So I'ma take an ugly nigga that treat me good and is about something, okay, over a nigga that look good. Bitch, you ain't even had the dick and you fucking stressed out over the nigga. Like, let's be for real. You ain't never had sex with him, like you said, and you ready to fucking cheat on your husband and you worried about him not fucking writing you back. Better yet, he got a girl too. You know he got a girl. So now you being a thought. You being a big time thought because you got a motherfucking husband and he got a girl. All the way wrong. This shit is all the way motherfucking wrong. But yet, you gonna write me and ask me for some motherfucking advice. Like, really? Did you, while you was writing this email, did you not reread the shit and think, okay, the shit is wrong? Okay, but yeah, you want some advice. So here's your advice. Here's my advice to you. The shit is dead ass wrong. Stop writing a nigga Ben on Snapchat, okay? And find something else to do with your spare motherfucking time. Like, be dedicated to your husband who's dedicated to you, because that's very rare and you don't find that shit. And obviously there's something that attracted you to your motherfucking husband, or else you wouldn't have been married to his ass 5 years, okay? So on that, I'ma just leave it as is, because I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one out there that feels this way. This is what I was talking about when I said it made me feel some type of way. And also be the fact that you just as dumb and naive as a motherfucker. So you feel like he's catching feelings for you because he didn't write you anymore or respond back to your messages. No, bitch, he's not responding back to your messages because he feels like he's wasting his time and he's not gonna get no pussy from you because you married and you're 7 hours away. So he's gonna fucking fuck with a local bitch where he can get the pussy right away and not have to keep fucking back and forth with you. That shit gets tiring too. Like, okay, I'm playing fiddle and feel with the bitch, but she not grasping. I'm not gonna keep doing this for some pussy. I can go locally and get the shit. He wasn't catching feelings for you, okay? He was fucking spending time trying to get some from you. Trust and believe, a nigga on social media, men on social media are really not into the female. Sometimes they go on these things for certain things, and I'm not really saying that to be mean and harsh, but let's just be realistic. What makes you think that the nigga's catching feelings for you? Because he said, what's the point? Okay, what's the point could mean a whole lot of motherfucking things. Not about catching feelings. It could be like, so what's the point? You seem more dedicated to your husband, so I'm gonna stop trying to get pussy elsewhere. Like, let's be for real. Don't try to run that game on me like, oh, he's catching feelings. That's what you want to believe, because your ass is catching feelings like him, or you're catching feelings for him. And so to make yourself feel better, you want to feel that, like, oh, okay, well, he's not writing me because he's catching feelings. Bitch, no, he's not writing you because he don't want to be bothered, okay? And you're just like another notch on his belt that he couldn't accomplish, so he's moved on to the next motherfucker. Okay. Wake the fuck up. You got a husband. Stop worrying about somebody else's man, okay? Because he got a girl. And honestly, he has a girl and he's flirting with you. So what the fuck makes you so special if he's doing it to his own girl? I would just really think like, okay, if he's doing that to his girl that he's been with, what makes me think that he's not going to want to cheat on me and mess with me? Let me stop fucking thinking about this man and messaging him and just chill with my husband. Duh. Common fucking sense. So, now that I have voiced my opinion and gave her some motherfucking advice, we're going to go on to the next one, okay? Yes. Please help. Any advice is greatly appreciated. You can call me Tammy. My name is Tammy. I'm 40 years old from the Bronx. I have 3 children, ages 23, 21, and 14. 2 girls and the youngest a boy from a different relationship. I recently got into an argument with my 21-year-old daughter that has honestly hurt me deep. It's affected me in the way I'm losing my hair from stressing, and I can't sleep because I feel as though I'm stuck. It first started off a year ago. My daughter has a 2-year-old son, my grandson. Last year, she got her own apartment and moved in her then boyfriend, which is her child's father. She started asking for help with money, and I didn't mind. But when I found out that her baby's father was working and living off of her, I fucking said something. She needed Pampers, and he fixed his weak ass on my daughter's bed in her house, living off of her, and had dropped his balls just enough to ask her, my daughter, if she deserved the Pampers and wipes for their baby. He told her he was leaving her because she allowed me to disrespect him and she didn't say anything. He left early August. We just had the argument this past Thanksgiving. That's when she told me I didn't raise her good enough, and she said she was younger, and I went to work and I went to school like I didn't care. How? Because I didn't have the time and money. She hated me because she didn't have an all new clothes or even a new cell phone or cell phone like her friends. How I wouldn't buy her stuff like how her friends had, and that she didn't have a father. She wanted her child to have a father, and I ran him off. April, I never sugarcoated anything about how or why I wasn't with my daughter's father. I showed and explained why he chose to not come see them or claim them. He was abusive and disrespectful in everything. When I left him for the first time and last time, it was because I said something about how he cheated on me and I caught 2 infections. He took his shoe off and beat both my eyes swollen shut, then punched me in my stomach until I threw up because I wouldn't have sex with him. But let my daughter tell it I didn't raise her good enough because she didn't have a father. Which brings me to my second problem. Last week, my daughter asked me to help her find her biological father. I reminded her about what happened and how he treated her and her sister when I left him. He never wanted anything to do with them. Last week, she found him just released from jail. Found him on Facebook. It surprised me. Niggas these days be fresh out the pen with Facebook accounts before they have a place to sleep. She told me today how she's been talking to him. He's been telling her I lied and I never cared for her. How he wants to come back and be a father and a family. But he has made it crystal clear in their text messages. I'm not giving you shit, so don't ask me. My money is for me, not you. We still talk several times a day, and she comes to my apartment almost every day when I get off from work. I asked her if that's what she wanted. She said yes, that she already told him she doesn't talk to me. So since I didn't raise her good enough and I've been buying clothes, Pampers, wipes, medicines, and toys, I told her good. Now you can try your supposed to be father that you threw in my fucking face to see if he still wants to do what he said with you and help you. Thank you. TT/Tammy. Okay, so Tammy is 40. She got 3 kids. Her daughter, who is 21, has a 2-year-old, which sounds just so familiar. Like, I have a 2-year-old grandson too and a 21-year-old daughter. But it's a little bit different, the situation. So basically, Tammy's daughter is disrespecting her because she just saying all kind of mean shit. You know, it's sad when your kids grow up and they just feel like they are grown enough to where they could just disrespect you and say whatever the fuck they feel is okay to say to you. Especially when you have helped them and you have done all types of things for them in life. Like, let's be real about this shit. I'm sorry, but, yeah, your father is a deadbeat. And I, you know what? I can relate. You know, each child has the right to know their father. However, if there's been situations where he's been abusive like that, then you know what? You have to find him on your own. He's walked out on us and walked out on you guys. I don't really want to have anything to do with you finding him, okay? And also, you ran off her baby's father? No, you didn't run off her baby father. She ran him the fuck off. Because if she would have stood on her own two feet and did not allow this man to run all over her and take advantage of her, then you wouldn't have had to say anything and he wouldn't have fucking ran off. He ran off because he's a weak ass motherfucker, and also because he didn't want to live up to his responsibilities of being a parent. What the fuck, man, you know, who got a baby with someone and says, do you deserve these Pampers and wipes? Like, let's be realistic, nigga. You made this baby. And even if you didn't make the baby and we're together and I asked you for some money for some diapers and wipes for my baby, don't give me the fucking audacity and let your balls drop and have the nerve to ask me, do I deserve the diapers and wipes? Because nah, bitch. Nah, we ain't about to sit there and ask nobody. So, you know something? Your baby father ran himself off, and you should be thankful that your mother said something, because had she not, he would have just kept on fucking using you and walking all over you until you didn't have shit left, and then he would have fucking walked out on you any motherfucking way, okay? Let's just be realistic. That's how it goes. You know, your baby father, Tammy, your grandson's father was a deadbeat, and it's unfortunate that your daughter didn't see it that way because she wanted a father for a child. Yes, here, I'm going to bring it back to everybody deserves to have a father in their life. However, if your biological father, baby father is a deadbeat asshole, then why would you want them in your child's life, okay? Nobody needs any toxic and unhealthy relationships, regardless if it's with their parents or not. Now, this brings us to the new situation where Tammy's daughter wants to see her father. So your daughter has got in touch with her father. He's just got out of jail and got a Facebook account. I will totally agree with you. Niggas be having Facebook accounts set up before they even have a place to stay when they get out of jail, or a job application set. Like, it's so pathetic and sad that people really rely on Facebook and Twitter and social media to just make their day go by. Like, they have nothing else to do. Me personally, I don't really care for social media. Like, I will post something up and I will keep it moving, especially with Facebook and Instagram. Like, I will like a couple of pictures on Instagram and then I will just get off, because honestly, I find it kind of boring, and that's just my take. Like, I don't really want to scroll down a page all day and look at people's pictures. Like, that's fucking boring as fuck, okay? Like, don't you got something else to do with your time? Like, who the fuck does that all day? And also on Facebook too. Like, people really be on Facebook. They make their life Facebook. That's all you want to do is be on Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. Like, really though? That shit is so fucking boring to me. Like, I don't really care to read about what the fuck you did today, what you doing later on, what you doing at the moment. I don't give a fuck. That's just my whole attitude. I don't care. I really don't care. So yeah, I can totally agree with you. Niggas be having their fucking Facebook account set up before they even have a motherfucking job and a place to stay. Now, your daughter's father has already told her in text messages that he ain't helping with her. He ain't helping her with shit. He ain't giving her no money. First of all, okay, that's great. I don't need your motherfucking money, daddy. However, the whole conversation is disrespectful. Like, I'm sorry, but you ain't about to be fucking sitting up here talking to me like I'm some fucking raggedy ass bitch. You crazy? Hell to the motherfucking no. I don't think so, dude. Is you out your motherfucking rabbit ass mind? Father or not, that was rude and disrespectful that he could say that. And for your daughter to tell you that you don't do, or you didn't raise her right because, let's see, she hasn't been raised right because you weren't with her father and shit. If that's how she feels, then let her continue to feel that way. She's going to eventually learn this on her own and find out, because she has a child, and that shit is going to bite her in the ass. You know what I'm saying? It's karma. It's karma, Tammy. But it's unfortunate that you have to drag your grandson in this. He's kind of like in the middle. Here's what you do. You know what? You don't have to stop buying diapers and wipes and clothes and toys because of the things that your daughter has said to you, because in reality, you're not doing it for your daughter. You're doing it for your grandson, because he's the one that needs that. And it's not his fault, your grandson's fault, that his mother is an asshole, or she's being, like my daughter Tati would say, a bunny hole, which means asshole, but we can say it a nice way. So it's not your daughter's fault that she's being a bunny hole, you know what I'm saying? But I wouldn't hurt my grandson. You know what I'm saying? Like, with me and my daughter, we have our disputes too. And I notice with her that sometimes she will just keep my grandson away from me. Like, they'll stay in the room all day. When I'm out in the room, she'll be like, come here, Cameron. And, like, that shit pisses me the fuck off. But I don't say anything because, you know what? That's your loss and his loss, not mine. Because he's still going to love me. And I don't be petty like that. So, you know what I'm saying? Even if me and her have a dispute and we've had disputes and shit, and I don't pay her no mind, and then I'll leave the house and I'll go shopping. And you know what? I still come back with something for everyone, including my grandson. I've come back with sneakers and clothes for him, not to make her happy, but because that's my grandson and that's just what the fuck I want to do. So let her be an ass and let her figure this out on her own. And in the long run, she will see that her father is a deadbeat and that he means no good to her. But you know what? You can't continuously keep telling her. She's going to have to learn this on her own way. So unfortunately, let her learn this on her own. But don't involve your grandson. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't deserve to miss out on anything. And even if she still needs help with something, still help her, because you're not really helping her. You're helping your grandson because he didn't ask to be here. You know what I'm saying? She will learn in the long run. And what I'm trying to say is just don't be petty. You know what I'm saying? Let your daughter learn that, you know what, her father's a deadbeat and he ain't shit. And just continue to help your grandson. That's all I can give you, the best advice, because that's what I would do in this case scenario. So you guys, I have to go because it's 9:45 and I got to bring my son to work. He has to be to work in 15 minutes and it takes me like 10 to get there. So yes, leave your comments below on this real talk. I love you guys. Stay diva and divalicious. And yeah, hit me up if you need any advice. And I love you.